Today's game between the Truett-McConnell Bears and your North Greenville University Crusaders. And now your starters for North Greenville University Lady Crusaders. At attack, number 4, Olive Bearley. At defense, number 6, Aaron McClure. At midfield, number 8, Candace Pettit. At attack, number 9, Aaron Grimsley. At midfield, number 10, Emily Colson. At midfield, number 11, Monica Colwell. At attack, number 13, Elizabeth Carey. At defense, number 15, Ansley Dobbs. At attack, number 17, Nikki Colwell. At defense, number 24, Natalie DeFringe. At midfield, number 29, Sam Poppleton. And at goalie, number 14, Lowry Gowing. Your Crusaders are coached by Michael Bain. He is assisted by Associate Head Coach Brianna Temples and Graduate Assistant and Director of Operations Aaron Kickleitner. And now, really quickly, your starters for Truett-McConnell. We have number 1, Rebecca Smith. Number 2, Erin Atkins. Number 3, Caitlin Cuban. Number 11, Christian Kersey. Number 15, J.C. Kaler. Number 18, Rachel Brown. Number 23, Jordan Westbrook. Number 24, Jordan Daly. Number 25, Morgan Dyer. Number 27, Janice Harkins. And number 33, Emily Shamblin. And now at this time, we ask you to please rise for the invocation and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Father God, we thank you for another glorious day. We also thank you for the sport of lacrosse. Bless both teams with great play today. And no matter result, bless them as we travel home from today's game. In your name we pray, amen. And now for the playing of our national anthem.
Good afternoon and welcome to Pepsi Field, home of the North Greenville Crusaders, who will take on the Truett-McConnell Bears. Play Coker later in the week. Let's see. Truett-McConnell still looking for their first win of the season. They are 0-7 for the year. And they haven't scored a goal in two straight games, so they're definitely looking to get some offense going today. North Greenville, on the other hand, coming off their first win of the season against the College of Charleston. Now, that was a club team, so we'll see what they can do against Division II competition. Our play-by-play man, Gray Sutherland, was asked to do the starting lineups today, so he'll make his way over here, and he'll have actual good commentary then. But until then, you're going to have to deal with me for a little bit. Unfortunately, we don't have statistics for Truett-McConnell. They don't have them on their website. For North Greenville, a player to keep your eye out on is number 17, Nikki Caldwell, who leads the team in goals with 14. Also, Monica Caldwell, number 11, is second on the team with 7 goals. And looks like we are underway. Shot heads out of bounds.
Blue, we're in blue.
How are you?
Again, if you saw our men's lacrosse games earlier this season, women's lacrosse is a completely different ball game. Not a lot of contact allowed. Goals a little bit further back. Even the sticks are different, so. And there's a goal for the Crusaders. see who it was in just a moment. It was number 13, Elizabeth Carey. And that is Elizabeth Carey's first goal of the season. So just about set for the draw. North Greenville on the move again. There's another goal.
Hey, that was another assist.
So that goal was by Monica Caldwell. Mentioned her just a minute ago. Her eighth goal of the season. I believe there was an assist on the play as well. Okay. And the assist was by Olive Burley, number 4. And that's her first assist of the season. And North Greenville on the move yet again, so showing a lot of aggression here. Look, some contact made. Bears trying to move it down the field. We're on the left side of the field for the first time today. And now a turnover. North Greenville with the number advantage at least. Now they're going to sit back and try to come up with the play. Again, Grace Sutherland, our play-by-play commentator, should be over here in just a little bit. Hopefully. So North Greenville getting off to a good start. There's going to be a turnover on the play. Bears will have the ball. Whistle blows. It's going to be a foul on Nikki Caldwell. McConnell having some trouble keeping the ball, and the whistle blows. And the shot, and it's good. So North Greenville goes up 3-0. You're good. That goal was scored by Olive Burley, her second goal of the season. So here comes the draw. Looks like it'll go to the Crusaders, and they'll be on the move yet again. And a nice stop there by the Bears. Another shot off the post. North Greenville still with possession, so an opportunity to take another shot here. Gets it in, and another goal, but it's called off. And a crease was called, so no goal. Truett-McConnell just really struggling to hang on to the ball. Haven't really gotten any decent passes off. Another one. So North Greenville's fourth goal of the half. So there's the draw. That last goal was by Nikki Caldwell. That's her, okay, that was her first of the day, but she also has an assist as well. So now Truett-McConnell on the move. Blows. And there's another goal by the Crusaders, up 5-0 now. Truett-McConnell falling behind early. Goal was by Nikki Caldwell, her second of the game. Nice save. It's number 16, Courtney Staples for Truett-McConnell. It's the goalkeeper. Now the Bears on the move. Goal for the Crusaders. That was Monica Caldwell. And that's her second of the game. Another draw, but again, the whistle blows. 19:38 remaining in the first half. North Greenville up 6-0. Gray's making his way on up to the booth. Not exactly an easy task, so. So now the Crusaders on the move. And that's another goal for the Crusaders, now up 7-0. So we're finally welcoming in Gray Sutherland, our normal play-by-play man. He always does a terrific job, especially compared to me, so. All right, so welcoming in Gray Sutherland.
Yeah, it's an interesting situation when they call you in to do a PA about an hour before the game.
Yeah.
And I hope everyone enjoyed that national anthem. That was me. So we're 9:15 through the ball game, and North Greenville is leading 7-0.
And so far there's been two goals by each of the Caldwells. Monica Caldwell with two, Nikki Caldwell with two, also Olive Burley with one, Emily Carlson with one, and Elizabeth Carey with one.
And here comes North Greenville on the attack again with number 17, Nikki Caldwell. Just mentioned her. Tries to swing around. There's a shot on goal, and it goes in. And I think that was Caldwell again on that goal. Gotta give her a hat trick today already.
Mm-hmm.
Now North Greenville's out in front, 8-0. Crusaders in control of this ball game from the start. Now we get ready for a draw. And immediately a whistle stopped and the official in the half field line motioning Truett-McConnell ball. So they will give Truett-McConnell the ball. And here comes Truett-McConnell on the attack. Number three lobbing it forward. That is number three, Caitlin Cuban. Ball goes out of bounds on the far left end. And it is North Greenville ball. So now North Greenville, once again, they are on the attack. Clear it past half field line. Several Crusaders giving chase, and it will stop right at the out of bounds line. And then a cluster of players, they say Truett-McConnell will have it. Historical event for North Greenville happened just within a week ago. They get their first official win, I believe, over College of Charleston.
Well, yeah, they did get their first win. Now, mentioned it earlier that College of Charleston is a club team, so they don't have an official NCAA team. This should be a more competitive game, although North Greenville has gotten off to a very good start, 8-0. Now, this is the first year of existence for both teams, not just North Greenville, so.
In this case, yes, it is. Two first-year teams doing battle. North Greenville trying to get their season, actually finish out their season with a good stretch of games here. Number four, Olive Barely on the attack. Trying to swing it around. Truett-McConnell is there on defense with Janice Harkins. Barely trying to swing it around again. Still waiting. She lobs it in. Here's a shot. And it goes off the goalie and in.
Goal by 29, Samantha Poppleton, her first of the game. That's her first goal of the season as well.
That's going to be a difficult one to take for Truett-McConnell. Goalie had it. Number 16, Courtney Staples, just couldn't get a beat on it and let it bounce off her and go in. Now we're looking at a score of 9-0 for NGU.
This one getting ugly fast. Still 16:40 remaining in the first half.
Women's lacrosse, they play two 30-minute halves compared to the men's lacrosse of four 15-minute quarters.
Right.
Same amount of time, but just a different way of doing it. So we're once again back in the attacking half for North Greenville. All the way on the far side, number 13 is Elizabeth Carey. Quick flip there to Monica Caldwell. Caldwell will try to drive in from the far side. Caldwell all the way back behind the goal. Trying to lob it forward. She'll do so. Here's a shot on goal, and it's in. Number 17, My goodness, Nikki Caldwell again. That's her fourth goal of the game.
Actually, that's her third.
Okay, so now she has a hat trick.
So both Caldwells now have a hat trick.
I think this is the type of game you want to have if you're North Greenville. A good way to get experience against another young team, much like yourself. This will definitely help getting into the conference slate.
That will be Nikki Caldwell's 17th goal of the season.
Because we also got teams like Limestone. They're very good.
Oh, yeah. North Greenville unfortunately saw that a couple of weeks ago as Limestone came to town and just absolutely dominated.
Now there's some contact after the draw, and official says Truett-McConnell ball. Ten nothing now, Crusaders out in front. We're halfway through the first half. Now trying to pick up the loose ball. One Truett-McConnell player against two North Greenville players, and finally number 29, Poppleton, picks it up for North Greenville, immediately starts racing the other way for North Greenville, looking to take it herself. And she'll head around the far side of the goal, look to try and swing it around. She'll stop halfway and turn back, try to swing it in. Oh, she'll hang on to it. She's still trying to swing it around. There she goes to number 13, Carrie. Here's Carrie on the far side. She's looking for some room. Still hanging on to it. And now she'll swing it around to Poppleton. And Poppleton will go back the other way. She'll fling it in. And that one loose in front of the Truett-McConnell net. And it goes in. I'm not sure if they'll count that as a own goal or if they give North Greenville, player another goal. Anyway, the score is 11 to nothing. Looks like they will credit that to Samantha Poppleton.
With an assist by Courtney Lane. So that's Poppleton's second goal of the season and her second goal. Both her second goal of the game and of the season.
After that, draw another stoppage in play, and once again, Truett-McConnell ball. Also, in another way, women's lacrosse is different from men's. Limited contact allowed in women's, and North Greenville certainly reminded of that constantly. North Greenville had a, what was it, Alan, 18 yellow cards coming into today's match?
Yeah, we'll look it up to find the exact number, but I know it's pretty high.
Here they go on the attack again. Swing it to the near side, number one, Brittany Battisti. She's looking to head around the other side.
Yeah, 20 total penalties for the Crusaders coming into this game. Their opponents only with four.
And here comes a shot, and it didn't go in. From number 13, that was Carey trying to get a shot on goal. And it looks like they're going to whistle it dead and give Carrie another chance on the far side of the goal. They will restart with Carrie in control for North Greenville. Here we go.
And I do understand that now that North Greenville is up by 10 or more goals, they have started a running clock now, so no matter what, the clock will continue to roll unless Truett-McConnell can cut it to less than 10.
Now here come the Bears trying to form an attack. Ball is loose on the far side. North Greenville scrapping for it. And number 24 comes out of the pile. Natalie DeFrenz. Heading down the far side. Now she's trying to cut it down the middle. She's on the far side of the goal trying to cut around the defender. She has a shot attempt and it goes in. And that is, or it should be from Natalie DeFriends. That is the case.
And yep.
So now 12-9.
I guess that's DeFriend. Is that how you pronounce that last name? I know that that's how you, Duquesne.
Yeah, Duquesne up in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, there. That's pronounced by that. So I'm assuming that's in the same country of origin. So
I believe that origin would be French.
Yes. And I think a timeout was taken. So the clock. Okay, one of the few times where the clock will come to a stop during the running clock.
Yeah. So North Greenville leading 12-0, 10:36 left in the first half here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
And we're back underway after another draw. Loose ball scooped up by number 10 for North Greenville, Emily Coulson.
Heading the other way. It's 12-0, North Greenville in control of this one from the start, of which I was not here for. Actually, yes, I was. I was over across the field, but never mind. So here comes Coulson trying to swing it around here on the near side. Still looking for space, one-on-one with her defender. Will lob it into play, hits a shot, and it does go in. That is from Monica Caldwell. That's an interesting number to see. North Greenville, 22 shots now. Yep, 22 shots. Truett-McConnell, nothing.
The goal was by Monica Caldwell, so that is a hat. Or no, that's four goals
for her,
and an assist by Emily Coulson. As the clock continues to run, that running clock that is now being implemented.
Great game so far for North Greenville. Only six turnovers to Truett-McConnell's 13. And here comes a draw. And it's loosened to North Greenville's attacking half, and it's scooped up by Haley Willingham. Willingham racing right down the middle. And she passes off to number one, Brittany Battisti.
Now Batiste will swing it around. Still spinning, looking for the net.
And
there was a shot made, but.
Don't know where the ball ended up.
It was a save by the goalie for Truett-McConnell.
It ended up.
I think in her net.
It ended up in her shorts. Wow, so an interesting save there.
Do what you have to down to 13.
Yeah, absolutely. So a save is a save.
After the goalie lobs it back into play for Truett-McConnell, North Greenville ends up scooping it up. Number 10, Emily Coulson. Clears it to Willingham. Now Willingham lobs it forward to Batiste again on the far side. She goes to number 11, Caldwell. Caldwell spins around the defender. She drives down the middle, puts in a shot in, and goal.
Forgot that the out of habit, stop the clock there for a second. So now 14 to nothing, Crusaders. And the goal was once again by Monica Caldwell, so her fifth goal of the day. She also has 2 assists and 9 total shots.
Monica Caldwell, the freshman at a Riverside High School in Greer. After another draw, ball is still loose, bouncing around and still battling around. Number 10, Coulson, Emily Coulson, scooping it up finally for North Greenville. And she'll head to the far side. Just a bit of a scheduling reminder, if you don't mind me mentioning, Alan.
Go right ahead.
We were scheduled to do Crusader baseball against Belmont Abbey. However, due to a lack of internet and certain weather conditions, they've had to reschedule. They are playing across the street right now, however.
We'll find a get an update on. Okay, game doesn't start until 7, so don't have a scoring update for you yet.
North Greenville, all the goals so far, 14 of them, none for Truett-McConnell. Looking for their 15th here. It was Caldwell slinging it out. Number 17, Nikki Caldwell. And some contact between Caldwell and number 11 for Truett-McConnell, it's Kristen Kersey.
We do have a softball update. North Greenville currently in Missenheimer, North Carolina at Pfeiffer University. They lost the first game in 8 innings, 2-1, so a pitching duel there that unfortunately the Crusaders ended up losing. Second game started at 4, and wow, Pfeiffer dominated that one, 8-0. Just 2 hits for the Crusaders in that game, so a rough outing there.
Couple of hard conference losses to take.
Yeah, North Greenville had won
4 in a row.
Yeah, 9 out of their last 10 games before today. So an unfortunate and unusual set of losses for them.
First couple of conference losses.
Yeah, they should be able to bounce back. Their next game will be March 18th, a doubleheader against Erskine here in Tigerville. We will not be broadcasting that. There is a different. Something else going on that day that we'll be broadcasting instead. So we'll let you know what the schedule is in just a little bit.
Nikki Caldwell almost had another goal, but now she's trying to spin around the defender. She tripped McConnell. Now here she goes looking for the net. We've got a whistle from the back official. And it looks like warning against Truett-McConnell, so North Greenville will get it to start with Caldwell pretty much looking right at the goal.
And with our viewership increasing by 2 since the last time we said it, we'll remind you. Currently there is a running clock implemented because North Greenville is up by 10 or more points, so that's why the clock continues to run even though whenever a goal is scored or the whistle is blown.
except for a timeout. The clock will right. still be stopped for a timeout.
Right.
Now here's Emily Coulson looking to head toward the near side. Now Coulson trying to, looking to swing it around. Now she cuts it back near side. Two Bears defenders on her, gets out of that jam. And she lobs it in, here's a shot, and it's in and good from number nine, Aaron Grimsley.
So that makes it 15-0. With 3:10 remaining in the first half. So as you mentioned, Gray, that goal by Aaron Grimsley, that's her first of the game, assisted by Emily Coulson. So Coulson with another save.
Assist.
Or, excuse me, you're right. So that is Grimsley's second goal of the season. North Greenville just getting out of hand, 15-0.
I think we can say they are trying to get their first official win against a team within their division.
And yeah, not trying to add salt to the wound for Truett-McConnell, but they're still looking for their first shot. They have not gotten off a shot yet. 25 shots for North Greenville, none for the Bears.
15 of those 25 shots have been goals.
And 15 turnovers for Truett-McConnell doesn't help things either.
On the far side is number 5, Willingham. Lobbing it back to number 11, Monica Caldwell. We're under 2 minutes to play until halftime. There's Caldwell trying to drive in. Caldwell lobbing it to number 10, Emily Coulson. And here comes Coulson trying to go down the middle, heads to the far side. Will not have a shot attempt as she spins out. And now whirls around the defender. She'll try to swing it around number 5, Haley Willingham. Switch places with number 9, Grimsley. Now back into the net of Monica Caldwell. Greenville still in control here on the near side with Willingham. Swinging it around, Grimsley. Now they go back to the far side.
Yeah, I think at this point, North Greenville's just being as conservative as possible. Just trying to take time off the clock.
Yeah, Emily Coulson almost had a shot, dropped it right in front of the goalie, scooped it back up though. And now we're under the final minute till halftime. Number 11, Monica Caldwell. Now passing far side, number 29, Samantha Poppleton. Approaching 30 seconds. And North Greenville can run this half out. That will not be the case next year, however, as the NCAA will implement a shot clock for Division II. That shot clock only in place for Division I currently. But a shot clock is coming for the rest of the divisions. See if North Greenville likes to take one more shot. We're under 10 seconds. And they will.
And
they
get it.
Should be Aaron Grimsley on that goal.
The clock did come to a stop.
4.6
seconds.
Okay,
it's within 2 minutes, it does come to a stop. So 16-0 Crusaders. We have been told that halftime will only last 5 minutes rather than the normal 10 because of how one-sided the game is.
So one more draw here in the first half, 4.6 seconds left to play with in the before half. And North Greenville comes out of it with number 17, Nikki Caldwell, in control. And that is the end of the first half with North Greenville leading 16-0 over Truett-McConnell. 26 shots for North Greenville, 16 of those goals. So we are at the half with 5 minutes until the start of the second half here on the North Greenville Sports Network as we step away for our halftime break.
So as we are set to begin the second half, we'll go over some first half statistics. Really just nothing for Truett-McConnell, a couple of ground balls and that's about it. No goals, no assists, not even a shot. They do have 7 total saves, 6 ground balls, 4 draw controls, 7 clears out of 13 attempts, and 15 turnovers. North Greenville with 26 goals, no saves because Truett-McConnell hasn't gotten a shot off. 14 ground balls, 13 ground controls, 11 clears out of 12 attempts, 7 turnovers, and 23 of the 26 shots were on goal.
Leading the way, scoring-wise, for North Greenville, Monica Caldwell with 5 goals. Just been informed that for the second half as well, there will be a running clock. With North Greenville leading 16-0. We change into the field. And here's North Greenville now going from right to left. Truett-McConnell would be going from left to right. And North Greenville on the far side. Number 10, Emily Coulson, controlling right now for Lady Crusaders.
Go over the first half individual goals. Monica Caldwell with 5 goals, 9 total shots. Nikki Caldwell with 3. Samantha Poppleton with 2 goals. Erin Grimsley with 2 as well. And then Olive Burley, Emily Coulson, Elizabeth Carey as...
We have another goal for North Greenville. Go ahead and give Nikki Caldwell another one. So that'll be her 4th. All right, as you go over the goal numbers.
Yep, so as I was saying, Olive Burley, Emily Coulson, Elizabeth Carey, and Natalie Dufresne, all with 1 goal in the first half.
So Nikki Caldwell with 4, right behind Monica Caldwell with 5. Now here will be the draw. And North Greenville immediately controlled. Nikki Caldwell wasting no time at all. Gets it to number 10, Coulson, Emily Coulson. Trying to head down the middle, Coulson is. Now we'll head to the near side. Now she'll head momentarily back behind the goal. Now bring it back out, still on the near side. Trying to swing it down the middle to number 11, Monica Caldwell. Caldwell has to spin out of some trouble.
All right, go back into red. All right, let's go red.
Monica Caldwell still in control. North Greenville just running some time.
Come on, 4 knees, let's go.
Yeah.
Now tries to pass it down the middle to number 8. Shot attempt goes wide by Candace Petit. Or Pettit.
Yeah, I'd go with Pettit probably.
Candace Pettit. And that ball should belong to the Bears. I believe their closest player was a Truett-McConnell player. And it is Bears ball.
Very good, Gray. See, we're getting lacrosse down. Maybe you are, I'm not, but still.
Well, first year team, first year calling it, so we'll figure it out.
Yeah, absolutely.
And North Greenville steals it away here on the near side, right? Behind the computer monitor. North Greenville heading back the other way with Pettit. She'll head to the far side. Swing it back, trying to get it to Emily Coulson, and she lost the ball, and here comes Truett-McConnell trying to scoop it up. They will do so. Number 3, that is Caitlin Cuban. And that ball heads out of bounds. And it's Crusader ball. So North Greenville gets it right back. Number 4, that's Olive Burley. She's heading, trying to swing it around near side. Now passes back to Monica Caldwell. Number 11, Monica Caldwell still in control, trying to run some clock for North Greenville. Now Caldwell heading to the far side. She's trying to head to the net now, and she'll pass near side instead. That is number 8, that was Pettit scooping it up and getting it back in for North Greenville. Now here comes Emily Coulson again.
Come on,
She stands just outside of the half circle at the front of the goal. She passes far side to number 13, Elizabeth Carey. Carey on the far side, swinging it around to the near side. Here comes Carey. Carey's still in control, trying to inch closer to that netting.
Somebody set a pick for Nikki!
And now here comes number 11. That's Monica Caldwell trying to drive in. She passes, or tries to pass, to number 10, Colson. Loose ball scooped up by North Greenville. That was Pettit that got to it. It is number 8, Candace Pettit, scooping up the loose ball for North Greenville, still on the far side. Trying to drive in from the far side. She swings it around to Poppleton.
Just not a lot going on right now.
No.
I mean, understandably so. North Greenville just continuing to be conservative, trying to run off the clock. Certainly don't want to be accused of running up the score.
I mentioned it earlier. No shot clock right now for Division II, as a shot in on goal is good by North Greenville. That is number 8, Candace Pettit. Nothing. North Greenville leads it after the goal by Candace Pettit. Clock continues to run. We're almost 8 minutes into the second half. But we just like to keep mentioning only the shot. NCAA will be implementing a shot clock, so hopefully games become, we'll have, give the team more opportunities to shoot.
Yeah.
It'll be a 30-second shot clock, just like it is in basketball. So here's the draw, and controlled by Pettit for North Greenville. North Greenville still on the far side. Loose ball on the turf in front of the Truett-McConnell goal, and numbers win the advantage for Nat for the moment for Truett-McConnell. And just as soon as that happens, number 44, Emily Williams, comes racing in to scoop it up for North Greenville. Gets it forward to Pettit. Hands off to Olive Barely. Barely trying to swing around to Poppleton. That's Poppleton for the moment. Here comes Poppleton. Shot. Is in it good. Might be wrong then.
Yeah, I think that was
number 21, Courtney Arndt. 26, Courtney Lane. Courtney Lane.
Yeah, and that was her first goal of the season, so you can understand why the Crusader side was going crazy.
Get your first
when that goal was scored.
Official goal.
Yeah, she does have an assist today too, and I believe that's her first as well. And it is, so yeah, good day for her. Got to start somewhere.
Yeah, I see North Greenville still listed as 0-6 overall, so.
Yeah, there were no stats. Meant to mention that earlier. There were no stats from the College of Charleston game, so I think we're still trying to figure out whether that went down as an official game or not. Again, College of Charleston is a club team, so. North Greenville did win the game. It was one-sided, so they.
Anyway, it's looking very good today for North Greenville.
Yeah,
their first official win, regardless.
Yeah. Truett-McConnell is an NAIA team, but still, I mean, hey, they're very NAIA, very competitive. We saw Ave Maria with the football team played here in Tigerville, and they were
last season.
They were competitive, so. NAIA isn't affiliated with the NCAA, but as the lights are coming on. You might hear the, I believe that's the lights coming on, some sort of buzz.
It is.
Yeah, so.
So they will shine down upon the field for the final 20 minutes. North Greenville still in control, not much else to mention.
Yeah, that's about all you can say. Truett-McConnell still has not gotten a shot off.
North Greenville's shooting percentage just amazing. 19 goals on 30 shots.
Yeah. Not sure if Limestone even, well, yeah, not sure if even the nationally ranked team like Limestone has had a day like that.
They probably did. They probably have.
Yeah, maybe, but I'm just trying to say, good day for North Greenville.
Yeah, it is.
Do want to mention our still plenty of time left in this game, but we'll go ahead and mention our next broadcast is tomorrow, men's volleyball against Emmanuel. That's a 7 o'clock p.m. start.
And that pass intercepted by Olive Barely. Truett-McConnell got the ball back momentarily, and Barely said not today and got it back for North Greenville. But as you mentioned, Alan, next broadcast will be tomorrow night, men's volleyball over in Hayes Gymnasium against Emmanuel College conference game. Then we've got two softball games.
No, those are live stats only. Okay. Baseball will be the 18th against Young Harris at 4 o'clock, so that'll be
okay.
We'll might have to get out of class a little early for that one. You should be okay, though.
No problem.
And then the 21st will be right back here, men's lacrosse against Coker. I said their name earlier. I was already thinking about that game. So men's lacrosse against Coker, March 21st at 7 o'clock p.m. So a rare night game here at Pepsi Field.
So they have them. They can have them.
Yeah, yeah.
Got lights.
You can hear the lights right now.
Yeah.
Still cutting on.
Just all part of the crowd noise. So North Greenville still in control. Number 4, Olive Barely, picking back up where we left off, trying to swing it in underneath. Loose ball on the turf, still loose. North Greenville battling for it, and we'll get it. Number 21, that is Courtney Arndt. North Greenville trying to swing around, far side again.
Yeah, it looks like, haven't mentioned it yet, but Truett-McConnell only with, looks like 4 subs. Looks like there's another player there, but she may be injured. She's not in not in uniform.
Yeah, only three players up, and look like they're ready to come in for Truett-McConnell.
There's one more on the bench that's not on the screen.
Another loose ball. This one will be scooped up by Truett-McConnell. Here goes number 1 for the Bears, Rebecca Smith, racing forward. And some contact by North Greenville will result. And Truett-McConnell retaining possession. Clock, however, still runs. So the Bears are suddenly in business, racing into the front, into their attacking half. Ball is still loose. North Greenville battling for it. Truett-McConnell has numbers and still on the ground. And now it's finally scooped up by number 16 for North Greenville, Sierra Sy. And now here she goes into North Greenville's side. About the best look Truett-McConnell has had all game at trying to get a goal. They had numbers forward too.
Yeah, they just keep losing possession. 21 total turnovers now. North Greenville with 12.
North Greenville around Truett-McConnell net, looking for their 20th goal of the game. Number 13, Elizabeth Carey, in control right now. Looking to try and swing it around to the far side, possibly. Now stops and comes back near side. Halfway through the second half, 15 to play. Now trying to swing it around, and pass mistimed, and now that one is picked off by number 20, Sarah Earl. And another whistle blown.
And I don't think we've seen a single flag thrown today either, so very clean game.
No cards either.
No. So that's always good.
So North Greenville get it right back. Number 20, Sarah Earle, cutting it to the near side. And funny note about cards is we found out they do exist for men's volleyball. And there's some contact, but number 17, Nikki Caldwell, retaining control for the Lady Crusaders. And another whistle blown, this time from the far side official.
And now the flag's thrown. Or no, that's
one
a shoe.
One of the Truett-McConnell players lost her shoe.
That's a...
The very neon green shoe just lying in the middle of the field.
Looked like a flag for a second. We were just talking about it, so I guess that was a little bit of wishful thinking.
And the clock has stopped.
Oh. Wasn't used to that. It's been a while since we've had to stop the clock for any reason.
Well, I guess for timeouts or equipment malfunctions.
Yeah. We appreciate you tuning in, the 5 viewers that we currently have. Not a lot of viewers today, but it's okay. With the first-year program, with the score being the way it is, and you can understand.
At least a few times this year, it's good we get to try our hand at getting to see some lacrosse in action.
Yeah, this is much better than the, I believe that was the Brevard game that I had to come up here and broadcast solo, as cold as it was. Man, I was still, man, it was just terrible that game. So this is a lot better. It's been very, very warm today. I believe it was supposed to reach the 80s. Not sure if it did or not. But
a high of 81 today. As another whistle is blown and the officials will have to confer, we have a yellow card.
Wow.
And Sarah Earle is coming out of the game.
So North Greenville not quite able to go penalty free, but they say it's 2 minutes.
North Greenville get to retain possession. Sierra sign on the far side. Control. North Greenville looking for their 20th goal of the game. Trying to swing it around far side. Number one, Brittany Battisti. And trying to get it underneath. Ball is loose. Batted around in the air by a couple of net sticks. And a whistle from the near side official will motion to Truett-McConnell.
Yeah, North Greenville is trying to hit that one away from that cluster of Truett-McConnell players, but ends up being in the possession of the Bears now.
Now here comes Truett-McConnell trying to get a possession. Number 10, Emily Colson, steals the ball away, but another official whistle is blown.
Yeah, they're just trying to get anything going that they can. Again, still not a single shot for Truett-McConnell. It's just been complete domination today. And now they might finally get one off, but it's mishandled.
Number 23 battling around for Truett-McConnell. Another official whistle blown, and it will retain with the Bears. Jordan Westbrook almost got away from North Greenville's defense. So Truett-McConnell is in business. Here comes Westbrook through the defense. She loses the ball again, still on turf, scoops it up, knocked away, knocked onto the ground again, and North Greenville's defense comes up with a big save with number 10, Emily Colson. And Battisti will clear it across the half field line for North Greenville and go back into their attacking half. That might have been that is definitely Truett-McConnell's best look all day.
And still just unable to get a shot off. Just you know, even without missed opportunities, I think the game still would be pretty one-sided. But they have had a few where they've had a chance to get something over there near that goal and just have been unable to do so.
Oh, no. North Greenville still looking for their 20th goal. It's around on the far side. Here's number 13, Elizabeth Carey. Now number 23, Natalie Hamrick.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious that the Crusaders have laid off here in the second half. At this point, it was 8-0 in the first half with around 10 minutes left. Now they have just scored
three. And here comes a shot, and it goes in. So that's North Greenville's 20th goal. I couldn't quite catch the number of the North Greenville player that got it, but they just caught the Truett-McConnell goalie way out of position. And Brittany Battisti. Oh, and that one was saved. That one was the earlier one.
It was Elizabeth Carey.
So she gets the
her second goal of the game.
And the 20th for North Greenville with under 10 to play. So while we wait for the next draw, number 10, Emily Coulson on the line for NGU. Play a little trivia about women's lacrosse.
Oh boy.
You know, Alan, if you know when and where the first women's lacrosse game was played.
I have no idea.
More on that in a moment. Ball goes out of bounds here on the near side. Game continues, approaching 8 minutes. North Greenville 20-0 is their lead. Pose the question if knew when and where the first women's lacrosse game was played.
Really, the first game was played by the Native Americans.
And that would be correct. The first recorded lacrosse game in history would be for the Native Americans. But the first women's lacrosse game was played in 1890 at St. Leonard's School in Scotland.
Wow.
And just to continue, Dustin, you were right. Native American game, which was first witnessed by Europeans when French Jesuit missionaries were in the St. Lawrence River Valley in the 1630s. So the first ever recorded lacrosse game played in the 1630s. First ever women's game, 1890 in Scotland. Since the inaugural game in 1890, it's expanded pretty much all over the country, predominantly strongly followed in the northeast part of the United States, but has expanded southward in North Greenville, Limestone, a lot of southerly teams picking up the sport.
Yeah, we're sort of seeing that with volleyball, men's volleyball as well. It's big on the west coast, hasn't really been quite as big on the east coast, but North Greenville, among other teams in the Conference Carolinas, starting up men's volleyball, so that's good to see as well.
Number 13, Elizabeth Carey, in control for North Greenville, as North Greenville has had dominant possession time for this ball game. They're just trying to run some clock. Already 20 goals.
Yeah, if there was time of possession on the live stats, man, I don't know if Truett-McConnell has handled the ball for a full minute. I mean, I just, you know, not trying to, you know, once again, not trying to pour salt on the wound or anything, it's just been complete domination by the Crusaders now. Again, Truett-McConnell, this is their first year of existence. It doesn't look like they have a lot of players on the team, so, you know, as the game goes on, depth probably becomes an issue for them. And just, you got to start somewhere, so. You know, they'll eventually get it together. Might take some time, but it'll happen.
Carey still in control for North Greenville as they head around the far side. Approaching the final 5 minutes to play.
Gray, I think we were going to have a trivia question for you.
Oh boy.
From Dustin.
Okay.
Question for you tonight is, what is the first Division II women's lacrosse championship played? What year?
Oh, Division II. 1977.
You're a little bit off on that one, Gray. It was in 2001 when CW Post beat Westchester 13-9.
Okay. That's fair.
You weren't too far off.
So now we're on the Truett-McConnell attacking half as the Bears look to be in business in the closing 5 minutes. Number 12, Kayla Rivers, trying to pass back out. Number 3, Caitlin Cuban, driving in. Here comes a shot off the goalie for North Greenville. Ball still loose, still on the ground, scramble for it. And North Greenville trying to avoid danger, and a save by number 12, Lowry Gowing, for North Greenville. But Truett-McConnell's gonna get it right back. And here comes Rivers, driving in for the Bears, swinging it to the near side. Still in business, drops the ball. And a 2-on-1 advantage, and North Greenville, with the only player in the area, number 15, Ansley Dobbs, comes out of the scrap with the ball for North Greenville. And now Battisti clearing it for the Crusaders. Number 5, Willingham, gets the pass. And the next pass is mishandled by Courtney Arndt. And no harm, no foul. Willingham scoops up the loose ball for North Greenville as Truett-McConnell battled for it. And now here comes Olive Barely on the far side. Alrighty then. So NGU in firm control of this game. Number 23, Natalie Hamrick on the near side with the ball for North Greenville. She passes out to number 10, it's Emily Colson. Nine Lady Crusaders have scored in this game for North Greenville to combine for 20 goals.
And once again, we really didn't see this coming, but part of that's because Truett-McConnell does not have statistics on their website, so we haven't really seen their stats coming into today. So weren't quite sure how aggressive they were, but it's one-sided is it's been a bit of an understatement.
Final 2 minutes with North Greenville leading 20-0. Trying to finish this one out down the stretch with Elizabeth Carey. Passing to the far side, Olive Barely. Now passing back, still on the far side.
Yeah, North Greenville just taking their time, trying to run out the clock. Truett-McConnell was finally able to get a shot off.
I think they actually had a couple. As we have a timeout called.
Timeout, wow.
Yeah. With a minute and a half left to play, so that'll stop the clock. Players will drop their nets where they stand. And that's another interesting thing about women's lacrosse. I was looking at some rules earlier, and when a whistle is blown, players must stop where they are and resume when play resumes from that exact same location. So that's why everybody laid down their nets.
Yeah. Well, it's interesting.
minute and a half left. North Greenville leads 20-0.
Assuming, well, yeah, I was going to say, I'm assuming that Truett-McConnell took that timeout. She's probably just trying to get anything, just trying to get some sort of momentum to end this game. And just have something to, you know, trying to end on a positive note. So, yeah. We'll see if they can do that.
North Greenville leads at 20-0 here on the North Greenville Sports Network. Minute and a half left, North Greenville leading 20-0. Take a look at the Conference Carolinas overall. North Greenville looking to improve, get their first official win. We'll try and get some confirmation on that College of Charleston game. But North Greenville looking to improve to 1-6. Not a conference game here against Truett-McConnell out of the NAIA, so conference record will remain 0-5. North Greenville has some ground to make up in the Conference Carolinas. Got eight other teams that do have lacrosse teams. Mount Olive, Limestone, Belmont, Abbey, Pfeiffer, and Lees McRae all leading the way with undefeated conference records. 3-0 for Mount Olive, 2-0 for Limestone, Belmont, Abbey, and Pfeiffer, and 1-0 for Lees McRae within the conference.
Just 1 minute remaining in this game. Again, there's just two halves in women's lacrosse, not four quarters like we see in men's. So this will do it, this final minute.
North Greenville just gonna try to be patient and run much clock as they can and keep it away from the Bears. Number 21, Courtney Arndt. Looking to drive in. I think she's trying to get her first goal of the game too. Courtney Arndt looking for the net. Drops the ball and flies up in the air. And now Truett-McConnell will be in business with 20 seconds left, looking for a clear. They bobble the ball. And now it's right back to Courtney Arndt. That's her stretch at number 5, Haley Willingham. She loses the ball and is scooped up by Truett-McConnell with 10 seconds left. A heave to the half court line, intercepted by North Greenville. And to the net with 3, 2, and 1 by Emily Colson. And she'll get one more pass to Courtney Arndt as they were trying to get her a goal. And the air horn sounds and that ends the game. 20-0 is your final score between North Greenville and Truett-McConnell.
So we'll go over some final stats.
Truett-McConnell did get one shot, but North Greenville got 32 of them and converted 20 of those into goals. Truett-McConnell with 8 saves, and North Greenville's 1 on Truett-McConnell's 1 shot. North Greenville picked up 23 ground balls to the Bears 13. Draw controls. North Greenville dominant in that department, 17 of Truett-McConnell's 5. Clear opportunities, almost perfect day for North Greenville, 20-22. 20 out of 22. Truett-McConnell just under 50%, 11 out of 24. Turnovers was the number of the day for Truett-McConnell, at 28 for the Bears and 18 for North Greenville. And then 28 shots on goal for North Greenville, 20 of those scoring, and one shot on goal for Truett-McConnell, and that translates to North Greenville's save.
Now that the game's over for the first time, well, we were. For the first time today, we reached double digits in viewership. We had 10 for about 5 seconds and dropped back down. But
leading scorer for North Greenville, Monica Caldwell with 5, and she is followed by Nikki Caldwell with 4.
And then after that, Samantha Poppleton, Elizabeth Carey, and Erin Grimsley all with 2 goals apiece. And then Olive Burley, Candace Pettit, Emily Carlson, and Natalie Dufresne, all with one goal apiece.
So North Greenville will get their first, this should be their first official win. So 1-6 overall for North Greenville. Thank you for joining us today here on the North Greenville Sports Network as the team runs across the field to get some cheers and claps from the fans that came out here to Pepsi Stadium. Next broadcast here on the North Greenville Sports Network tomorrow night. Men's volleyball in action over at Hayes Gymnasium. We'll bring that to you starting at 7 o'clock. Thank you for listening here on the North Greenville Sports Network as women's lacrosse is victorious for North Greenville, 20-0 over the Truett-McConnell Bears here on the North Greenville Sports Network.